I would like to welcome you all on behalf of Mansoura for this and her wonderful team of volunteers for this amazing event, exhibition. Iranian Women's Movement Museum is a research project initiated by Mansoura, activist and researcher, Mansoura Shojaei. This oral history project aims to present the Iranian women's movement through a combination of biographies, events, art, and literature. The Iranian Nobel Prize winner, Ms. Shirin Ebadi, first introduced the idea to Mansoura. And we are honored that Ms. Ebadi has accepted our invitation to be here during this opening ceremony. I am grateful that I have had the opportunity to host Mansoura and her great project at our university, Vrije Universiteit Amsterdam, since September 2017. I'm also grateful that my colleague, Dr. Kathy Davis, who is expert in women's biographies, to support this project. However, I have to emphasize that all the credit goes to Mansoura and her great team of friends and comrades who made this possible. This exhibition is the first stage of Iranian Women's Museum project, which showcases handicrafts made by women inmates in Evin prison. The stories and imaginaries connected to these handicrafts make them much more than just objects. Each handicraft has a story to tell about the biography of the women who made it. They tell stories about the struggle for justice, the love and passion of activism, and the pain of facing many forms of injustice, both inside and outside the prison. But the handicrafts also tell stories of travel through time and space, due to the untiring efforts and commentary of many people around the world who have made it possible for the handicrafts to reach audiences beyond borders. In order to understand and feel these stories, we need imagination to go back in time and space and become part of their journey. We need imagination to go back in time and space and feel the history of Iranian women's passion in their struggle for an equal world, their amazing sacrifices to go beyond their individual gains and become part of a transnational women's movement. We need imagination to feel the pain and isolation of women in prison, who found the creativity to send us messages of perseverance through their handicrafts made with love. Imagine all the love, solidarity, and immense creativity that went into making these artifacts, which are now traveling beyond the thick walls of prisons and beyond national borders. Try to extend your imagination as you look at these artifacts. By doing so, you bring a history of courage, resistance, and struggle for justice and equality alive. Through this power of imagination, we can connect worlds, and then we can break any kind of isolation, be it a prison or a national border. Then these handicrafts can become a symbol of the connectedness of strugglers for a better world. But they do even more. When they reach us in a democratic context, such as the Netherlands, they remind us that the freedoms we enjoy did not come on their own. Some people have paid a high price for these achievements. They ask us not to take our freedom for granted, but also to remember that when we give shelter to these kind of projects and to activists such as Mansoura, we are acknowledging that if we do not support courageous activists in their struggle for freedom and justice, we are abandoning the people who made our freedom possible. Situating this project within academia does more than just show that we as scholars connected to the world outside the university and beyond our comfort zones. Having an academic setting also helps such projects use thoughtful documentation practices and craftsmanship or craftswomanship to collect biographies. Connecting academia to activism is necessary for co-creating knowledge that is essential for addressing complex issues of inequality and injustice, which are becoming increasingly dominant in the world. Only through our joint efforts and shared responsibilities, we can tackle the societal complexities we are facing today. So the final message of these handicrafts is for us to join hands and resources which are essential for the continuity of this valuable project, and let the handicrafts travel all over the world to connect us even more in all ways possible.